I'm trying to think about what this could be. I'm not sure if it's a worm that's still inside an egg or something else. Hello, Naid. I heard you started your Twitch channel, but I couldn't watch. I also have no idea what all these little things are. Hello, says Steve. How are you doing? Doing okay, still alive. Thanks. Yeah, these are actually amoebas that built a kind of armor out of debris and the remains of their food. Okay. I don't know. I've never done it. I just drink it all at once. I don't know. I mostly drink water. Sometimes I like to drink soda, but I don't buy much. Just a little artificial pond with some water plants. I've kept it in a jar for several days. Just took it, these flatworms weren't there. Only a few days ago they started appearing. And I think every other time I took samples from that same pond, they weren't there. So it kind of varies. And it's kinda in an equilibrium. There are a few algae that are eaten by snails. The snails poop, and then other stuff can eat that poop. And the algae grow kinda slowly, so in the end they get all eaten. But when I run out of algae, I just add more. So it's a tiny ecosystem. I think it's kind of both. They are organelles, but the theory is that at some point they were algae that they ate and then were integrated in the organisms. But now they are a specific organelle. And this one's just divided. I think they are stuck. I don't know what the thing is, but it looks like it's sticky. They generally move around while they eat. I think these ones have only one eye. All the other rotifers I've seen have two. That red thing is the eye. It's interesting, all the things you can do when you don't have a skeleton. It pooped. It's the same thing where the rotifers were stuck. So they were stuck in the poop from the flatworm. But I don't understand something. Two of the important groups of animals are those who eat and poop from the or from different holes. And there are, I think there are three types of worms. One of them is the flatworm, we eat and poops from the same hole. But the other two have different holes. So I don't know if the name worm is just it's just a name or they are actually closely related. And this one is dividing. it's a filter, dark field filter. I made it by cutting a circle of plastic and painted it with black paint in the center. So most of the light is blocked and it looks dark in the background, but the light that comes from the edges of the circle hit the specimens at an angle, and the light is diffracted to the lens. Here is one that just died. Why? It didn't do anything. It died on its own. It's kind of the same. I don't know why they died, though. still, they are made very exactly, so I think maybe they could be improved. Remove the blurriness and stuff. I don't know what it is. It is kind of a protective shell. Out of these ones, this PC make it, but I don't know what it is. I thought rocks would be everywhere, all kinds of rocks. have some of those too. Do you want to see them? These are cyanobacteria. These are the ones that produce oxygen. They are the first photosynthetic organism, I think. And they are the ones that causing the oxygenation that extinguished most other organisms, that causing those accumulations of iron. They are called cyanobacteria. They're everywhere. this one is an amoeba. I had never seen them in this sample. I don't know if it was there from before, or I contaminated it from another. Yeah, that would be nice, but I don't know if there is enough interest to make them like that.
Thank you.
I think there are people that have made their own electron microscopes. If it isn't too hard, maybe someday I could learn to make one. All or most of these bubbles that are here are from the oxygen that the bacteria are producing. I think the brand is Opto Edu. It's kinda cheap. Yeah, I like it. I think it's made for educational purposes, to use in schools and stuff like that. The only thing that made it more expensive is that it's trinocular, to attach a specialized camera. It doesn't have any fancy capabilities like DIC or stuff like that. Those might be much cheaper. And I don't know if you can change the camera. Thanks. These are cyanobacteria that I took from a pond a long time ago. I took a water sample from a pond, but I forgot to open the lid for months, so almost everything inside died except the cyanobacteria. Yes, they like to move a lot. They are actually bacteria, so they can move. Here it's easy to see the movement. thing is moving inside, so I think it might be an amoeba. This is the test of an amoeba, and I think it's entirely made of the atom's remains. It's like a mosaic. another nematode. There always has to be one. Getting late, so I stop it here. Good night and thanks for watching. I'll just write someone to end up. thank to you for coming.